Hey guys, coming to you from my living room here tonight, and Jordan's been working on another project, and we thought you might like to take a look at it. If you're familiar with some of our past videos, you may have seen a couple of the air cannons that Jordan has built, and this is the most recent model, and I thought it was looking pretty darn menacing, as you can see, so I thought we'd take a look at it and see what you think. What he's done this time, he actually had a couple of other air cannons, and he took one of the existing ones and kind of modified it to make it into this one. So what he's done, this is the main air chamber, and this is, you know, just PVC pipe, and it has a typical valve stem down here, a Schrader valve, just like you'd have in a, you know, bike tire or anything like that, and that's what we use to pump it up. And then to release the air, it has a 3/4 inch ball valve right here. And eventually, we're going to start using those powered sprinkler valves because they're real quick and you can actually use a trigger. But for right now, this is what we had, so he used it. And then it goes through a PVC barrel. And it'll fire just about anything that you shove down the barrel, basically. Another thing that he's added to it, as you can see, is a bayonet. And really just to make it look frightening. And he'll probably take that off when we're actually out using it, but it does look pretty mean, that's for sure.
It would work. It's not the strongest thing on earth, but it would still work.
Yeah. Should you want to stab people?
Should you want to?
Which we do not condone. But anyway, the main feature that this one has that the others didn't is...
I put a bike pump on it.
Right.
So I can pump it while I'm out shooting instead of having to run back up to the house and use an air compressor.
Right, because previously we were running back and forth with every single shot. And at least this way, I mean, he could be down by the pond or whatever and pump it up. It's pretty cool. He took a regular, you know, pump that has the little foot pads down here, and he chopped those off to make it a little more sleek here. And then up here on the T-handle, he chopped that down because you don't really need all that. And so it'll work just fine. And then this one actually has a gauge on it, which is nice. And this pump will go up to 120 PSI, as you can see. But we never pump this over 100 PSI, just for safety's sake. Actually, the weakest component on this entire gun is the valve stem, and it's rated for 150 PSI. So if we stay at 100 or less, we should have a good margin of safety, you know, which is always important. But like you said, it takes a little while to pump up, but at least you can do it without having to come up and hook up an air compressor and all that kind of stuff. Now, one of the other things he's done, if you want to flip it over so we can see the stock, he took just a regular piece of, it was actually an old deck board we had, and he carved out this stock so you can see. It even has, it's a thumb hole stock, so your hand, you can show them how your hand just fits right in there. But, I mean, that's a really comfortable grip for sure. And I think it worked out really nice. He basically just carved that out with a saw and a Dremel. So.
I actually just hit this on the ceiling.
Yeah. The thing is so massive, it's just crazy. But anyway, right now it's pretty cold outside, and we usually don't like to shoot PVC guns when it's like below 50 degrees, just because there is a chance that it could become brittle. So we're gonna either wait for a nice warm day to shoot it for you, or we may set up something down in the basement so we can shoot it once or twice just to show you how good it works. But anyway, it's gonna have sufficient power for sure. But anyway, guys, we just thought we'd give you a quick look at it tonight, and hopefully you find it interesting. And then we'll come back another day and shoot some targets with it and that kind of stuff. So anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll see you later. Bye.